I am working with a different camera. I bought this camera about a year ago. I just couldn't figure out how to use it. I couldn't download the video onto my computer so that I could edit. It's a complicated camera. It does lots of fun stuff. The complications overwhelmed me, and I just didn't do anything with it till yesterday or the day before. And I picked it up. I said, I spent a bunch of money on this camera. I should use it. It came with a card reader, so I popped the card reader in. It showed up on my computer. I was like, what the heck? I tried before and I couldn't get it to do it. Bingo Zingo, I'm gonna use this a little bit more. This is a test. Just like everything else in my life. It's just a test. I'm just figuring it out as I go. Let's get that piece cut and we can take a look at it. We're looking at this corner here. I have a piece of metal for that. I'm gonna cut it and install it 34 and a quarter. I've cut the metal and I actually installed it. I am also working on finishing this, which is the controller for the heated floor. We're gonna see if I can't get that running. I'd like to have the floor heated so that when I paint, it's all an adventure. I'm going to go to the store since this is where the washer is gonna go. I want it sitting on a rubber mat to help with sound vibration through the house. In the meantime, I was over here working on this unit here. Installing this, and it cracked. The fixtures here aren't the same as the ones in Europe. A two-gang plate, and I cut a hole so that this would fit into it. And when I was putting it together after I had it all wired up, I broke it, so now I'm gonna make a new one. This is an isolation mat that I have to cut and fit into here. Here's the aftermath of the trimming. There's the space. I wish they had a different color other than black, but well, that's what they had. I'm also going to use these. It's polypropylene with another high density foam. Sit on here and isolate even more. That's the idea. I don't know if that's the reality, but that's what I'm thinking.
Somehow I changed the setting on the camera. It shot this video. I don't know what I did, but it's the only footage I have of this day. So I'm using it. Close your eyes if you don't want to see it sideways. Just listen to the words. I'm sorry. Life's an adventure.
My brother came over. I just picked him up from the ferry. He is down at the beach with the dog, taking care of her. This is the clothes washer and dryer combo. This is the backside. We're going to move it downstairs into the basement, and then we're going to lift it into the space. I've got these hoses here, and I don't know if I mentioned to you about this, but if you saw these cracks that looked like I was a poor craftsman, and actually that section, lift that off so I can get to the backside of the washer, make the hookup, because I knew this was going to be tight. And also that space being able to be removed means that I can access that part of the house. I can finish off all the water stuff. I'm gonna do that tomorrow. I'm looking at this little pipe sticking out of the wall, and it's got a lot of paint and overspray on it. What I need to do is I need to remove all this paint and overspray. I'm gonna do that with a brace of wheels. I'm just gonna go around this thing. And I'm gonna clean this all up. What you didn't see.
This was a very difficult valve because the pipe was really short and my brain was working and my finger on the camera wasn't. I used my pipe cutter, cut the tip off of the pipe, put the discussion ring on and valve after that.
I could mount the toilet when I'm done painting the floor. I'm now going to move on to these two. Gonna get the drill, clean these up. I've used this drill to clean off most of the paint and overspray from the wall. Some sandpaper here, which I will just give it that nice copper look. Grab the bucket. What I'm doing, I'm going around
and the blade is cutting at the tension that I put it on. And then when I tighten this down a little bit, this pushes the cutting wheel into the copper. And then I go around again. I go in both directions, tighten, go in both directions. Drain out a little bit.
First I put on a nut, then I put on the compression ring, and then the valve. Then I tighten the valve and nut together, and the compression ring creates a waterproof barrier squeezing on the pipe and the valve interior.
And then just a touch more. You don't want to over-tighten. Just a little bit more, and then you're good. And that's on. Let's get this wall cleaned up. Got the second one on, looks good. We are going to move to here. We've got this one done. And what are we looking at here? We're looking at a cold water supply, hot water supply with a tap going to a dishwasher, a little mini dishwasher. Here we are, many, many years later. That's pretty cool. The LED lighting makes it flash. And I believe I just started the cycle. Yep. Wow, that's pretty cool because in real life they're just on, but they're pulsing in the camera. All right, so we have this installed now. I just have to go get the instructions in. All I need to do is enjoy that I got that up. Third time's the charm. It's been a successful week for me. My last video was mushrooming. I've been spending my time doing pickup work. The plumbing fixtures have their stops on them, so I can install sinks and stuff on top of it. I also have my washing machine installed. I ran two loads. The isolation setup that I have going works. I don't hear it upstairs at all, so it's completely separate from the house. However, it is loud down here, but as you can hear my voice all the time, this is a big empty box with hard surfaces. It does echo in here. But when furniture and stuff comes in, it'll be quieter. And that will have a door that you can close after starting your cycle. I did get this hooked up and operational. I have run it. I brought it up about half a centigrade. I ran it for roughly 12 hours. This is a big floor. What I really need is a bigger heat source. So this does run. It does operate. I had it going. I have to tweak it. For me, that moves this along quite a bit. I'm really happy. I wanted to run the floor, the heat in the floor, but I'm just not gonna burn the electricity just for that. I'll just have to turn the air temperature up in here and warm it that way. It's a little bit more efficient. I will soon be using all the rest of the paint that I have to coat this floor one more time after I crack fill. And what else am I gonna be working on? I'm gonna be working on the storage space. We'll see you in the next video. I appreciate you watching. I appreciate your interest. It's really encouraging to see people actually watching the video. Make them to be watched. I hope you understand what I'm doing here. This is totally unscripted. This is a day in life. Dare I say that? I guess I do dare to say that because I just said it. It's not for everybody. That's okay. Maybe the shape of my nose or my teeth not being straight is something that annoys you and you won't watch again. But for those of you who do, I love you. I send you my love. All the good wishes that come with a healthy life. And I'll see you in the next video.
Keep on doing what you do, doing what you do. Just keep on doing what you do.